Where are you calling from?
Our Carolina, and it's about teenage before, or right up. Yeah, people on a vigilant care standoff.
Oh, Costa, Wabby.
Now, these are AI programs talking. Can you believe that? In this video, we'll explore various advancements in audio generation by AI systems. You will definitely be mind blown after watching this video. We'll cover three unique examples, and honestly, the third one is my personal favorite. Let's dive in right away. Researchers from Meta AI and the Hebrew University of Jerusalem revealed AudioGen, a generative AI model that can make new audio from scratch. All you need is a text description of what you want to hear. AudioGen can also continue existing audio input from providing only 1 second of initial sound. The researchers say that the AI model can solve hard audio problems. Let's go through some of these problems. Because of how sound moves through a medium, it can be hard to tell objects apart. For example, separating multiple people who are simultaneously speaking. This is made even harder by the way recordings are made in the real world. That is, most audio forms have background noise or some form of reverberation, which can affect how AI separates quality audio from pure noise. Another problem is that there aren't many text annotations, which makes it hard to scale models. AudioGen provides high-quality audio compared to previous AI models. For example, it can tell the difference between sounds and objects, like when several people are talking at the same time. It can even create noise in the background, like reverb. The researchers put together a total of 10 audio datasets with matching text annotations to help the model learn from more data. This means that overall, about 4,000 hours of audio data were used. After training, AudioGen can make new sounds that weren't in the dataset. For example, it could simulate whistling while walking through a forest with birds chirping in the background. As the following video shows, all you need is a text prompt. The model can also generate music and even sing, but it was not designed for that purpose, and there aren't many ways to control it right now. A team of human evaluators reviewed the results of AudioGen. More than 85% of the 100 randomly chosen audio samples had at least two concepts, meaning that, for example, a dog barks while a bird sings. The research team looked at a total of 4 models. The models had anywhere between 285 million and 1 billion parameters. That's an okay size compared to other large language models that are in the hundreds of billions. The team thinks that AudioGen is the first step towards better text-to-audio in the future. AudioGen still needs some improvements. One thing the model is not yet good at is producing understandable sentences, as you've seen from the several examples we've shown so far. This may be fixed by carefully crafting speech data into the model. Another limitation of the model is understanding the temporal order of a text. What does this mean? For example, it's hard for the model to distinguish between a dog is barking, then a bird humming in the background, versus a dog is barking and a bird humming in the background. One requires the bird humming to begin right after the dog barks. All in all, the results from the model are pretty impressive. I'm definitely eager to see what the next few iterations will look like. Who knows, artists and video directors may be able to generate all kinds of audio and then edit them for their art. You can imagine Dr. Dre sampling an AI audio snippet for his album in a few years. AudioGen is not the only audio model coming out of the Meta campus. GSLM is another groundbreaking audio model that can simulate emotions. So now we're taking that a step further. People communicate nonverbal cues such as intonations, emotional expression, pauses, accents, and rhythms in their conversation, and all of which are vital in human interactions. However, today's AI systems are incapable of capturing these complex and expressive signals because they are trained on only written text, which captures what we say, but not how we say it. These aren't trivial actions. They are critical for recognizing the context of an engagement, whether it's sarcasm, impatience, boredom, or something else. GSLM generates audio with various expressions like giggling, yawning, and crying. Yes, you heard right. AI that laughs. Check out these samples.
They were deep in the primeval forest. They were deep in the primeval forest. They were deep in the primeval forest.
You mean for this state, General Alberta?
You mean for the state, General Alberta? You mean for the state, General Alberta?
2 days ago, Jean learned where her father's men were hiding.
2 days ago, Jean learned where her father's men were hiding. 2 days ago, Jean learned where her father's men were hiding.
They are greatly delighted with anything that is bright or giveth a sound.
They are greatly delighted with anything that is bright or giveth the sound.
They are greatly delighted with anything that is bright or giveth a sound.
Wait till you see what other examples we have. Meta plans to use these findings to improve its metaverse experience as the world becomes increasingly digital. One of the technical obstacles to capturing emotional expressiveness in speech is that such expressions frequently affect multiple parts of language at the same time. When people switch from expressing delight to expressing rage, they may use different words and incorporate cries, grunts, and other nonverbal vocalizations. They may alter their intonations and rhythm, and even their voice quality as a result of stress. That means that even minor timing shifts or delays might affect the smoothness of the utterance. Take these two examples. I really love artificial intelligence. I really love artificial intelligence. You can see the timings are different with these phrases, and it affects how we perceive speech. Okay, ready to be mind blown again? A newer version of the model can mimic real-time chit-chat between two AI bots. Usually, when people are involved in conversations, there are occasional overlaps or pauses, which will be useful for developing agents such as virtual assistants. These assistants should be able to interpret sophisticated social cues and signals, like interruptions, as well as positive or negative feedback when having a chat with someone. Let's first have a look at some examples.
Hi, my name is Dee. How are you?
What's good. Your name? My name is Debbie.
Debbie. Where are you calling from?
Our Carolina, and it's about teenage before, or right up. Yeah, people on a vigilant care standoff.
Oh, Costa, Webby.
Yeah, yes. But she has at least big town here from the theater one by was. You can't imagine.
Oh, Isolone, I know. And they are Peace Boys. They're not learning to. Also, a Peace Boys, also, they get the best on the theater. And
it's
about to change.
The model is great at taking turns and letting the conversation flow. However, as you probably noticed, the audio generated after the prompt beep is unclear. It's hard to make out what the AI is saying. The authors plan to improve the clarity of the model by possibly training it on more data. Gaps and pauses are instructive because the overlapping speech and nonverbals, like or might indicate agreement, disagreement, or a willingness to speak out. Until now, such richness has been very difficult to express with AI. The goal of GSLM is to imitate speech content, nonverbal vocalizations, and timing all at once. The way the chit-chat model works is straightforward. Two identical transformer models are taught to forecast what to say next while paying attention to the other via what is called cross-attention. The model is prompted by 10 seconds of real conversation and then continues with its own version of small talk. In the near future, Meta AI plans to use the model as an AI assistant for question answering, for example. Imagine talking to Siri, but one that's smarter and shows a range of emotions. It can laugh at your jokes, especially the one no one else finds funny. What did the tomato juice tell the fries in the marathon? Funny, yes, no? Comment what you think the answer is. Speech-to-speech translation, or dubbing, is one of the other use cases. Dubbing is often done by converting audio to text, translating it, and then converting the text back to audio. You can see the multiple difficult processes involved in this. GSLM will convert audio directly and add depth and expressiveness where necessary. If you've not really been impressed so far, then this final model will do the trick. And I mean this sincerely. The model is Google's AudioLM. The model can generate realistic speech and piano music by listening to audio only.
Rolf, we know not how to call you lord or lady. We have lived too long in the forest and are now...
Our first impressions of people are, in 9 cases out of 10, mere spectacle reflections of the actuality of things. But they are impressions of something different and more...
The team claims the model is better than GSLM in terms of long-term consistency and high fidelity. This means that the voices AudioLM produces is far more coherent compared to other models. In simple terms, you can actually understand what AudioLM is saying. The piano melody produced by the model is also very consistent and sticks to the overall rhythm of the sequence. This model outperforms other AI systems by focusing on two very important parts of audio creation. It first focuses on the semantics of the audio, that is, how the individual components of the audio build up to create meaningful outputs. The model also focuses on acoustics. This is how the audio waves vary at a lower level. Learning from the acoustics enables the model to create richer quality audio samples by varying the different wavelengths. To present this more clearly, let's first look at the model based only on acoustics, without any semantic representation.
And that aggressive spirit Prince Carl Albert embodied had long been drawing these powers to Didhauer and Downs Bertine, air, we, and mustard, air.
You immediately lose track of what is being said after the first 4 seconds of prompting. The audio is more gibberish than English. This is similar to the GSLM example we saw previously. Now let's look at the model with semantic encoding and different acoustic settings.
This transient spring and lighting up are beautiful, a glamour beguiling our senses.
This transient spring and lighting up are beautiful, a glamour beguiling our senses.
This transient spring and lighting up are beautiful, a glamour beguiling our senses.
This transient spring and lighting up are beautiful, a glamour beguiling our senses.
Because of the semantics, the audio is now more understandable, and the acoustics provides different waves with varying perspectives. So you can see how semantics is important in building up audio from AI. AudioLM was trained on 60,000 hours of speech data, and another version was trained on 40,000 hours of piano music. Now that's a lot of piano lessons to sit through. In order to validate the results, the Google team asked human evaluators to listen to brief audio clips and determine whether they were authentic recording of human speech or a synthetic production by AudioLM. The ratings showed that 51.2% of the time, humans could successfully differentiate between an AI and an actual human speaker. That's just above a 50-50 chance of getting it right, almost like a random coin toss. This indicates that, for the average listener, speech produced by AudioLM is difficult to distinguish from real speech. At the moment, the Google team is not releasing the model to the public due to their internal AI principles. They want to first understand and reduce the likelihood that people might mistake the brief speech samples produced by AudioLM for real speech. This is no surprise considering we are in the age of AI-generated media, from text, images, and video to audio. Misinformation and disinformation are huge concerns, and companies are scrambling to ensure that they don't add to the flame of toxicity in our society. With AudioLM, you can simply take a 4-second snippet from anyone and get it to produce content, which can then be disseminated. In recent news, we've seen backlash against the Anthony Bourdain documentary because the filmmaker used AI to mimic his voice. Or on the music side, Jay-Z suing a YouTube channel for impersonating his voice. In order to avoid malicious and unauthorized use, the team also trained a detector that can find synthetic speech produced by AudioLM with 98.6% accuracy. This shows that the audio produced by AudioLM is very simple to detect with an AI program, despite being almost indistinguishable to some human listeners.
This transit, spring, and lighting up our dreams by its brilliancy and beauty, a power which, if we shut our eyes to it, will not shut for the moment with a pale rose glow, and gleaming burnished bright with a pale green light.
Some images, like some sensations, which produced by the light of nature in all creatures, are subject to various conditions, as in
The team also plans to implement other technologies like audio watermarking to increase safety. In the future, AudioLM could be extended to other types of audio like multilingual speech or multi-instrument music, as well as text-to-speech or speech-to-speech translation software. I'm excited to see multi-instrument music because that'll go past only piano to having several drums, guitars, and possibly even vocals. I bet many of you are now impressed, especially with AudioLM. What is the most important application of AI-generated audio? I want to hear your suggestions, and if you like this video and want to explore some more, check out this video where we talk about AI for video generation. You won't be disappointed. Thanks for watching. I'll leave you with AI-generated music for the outro. Until the next video, it's goodbye.